Welcome to Aussie Indian. I have one of the legends of Australian cricket, Greg Chappell. Greg, welcome to Aussie Indian.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
Australian team is going through a bad patch. I think probably the worst I have seen in my lifetime. If I ask you to put a finger on a couple of things which is resulting in this performance, what would you say?
Oh, look, I think I've been around long enough to see this four times. At the end of an era, most teams go into a decline for a few years while they rebuild. I'm not as pessimistic about things in Australian cricket as a lot of the media are talking about at the moment. We've got some good young cricketers around the country, and I have no doubt that looking at our bowling attack at the moment is developing very quickly. And if two or three young batsmen can really start to put their hands up this domestic season in Australia, it won't be long before I think Australian cricket will be looking much healthier. So I think it's a fairly natural occurrence that does happen at the end of a really strong era like we've had over the last 20 years.
Mm-hmm. You have an intimate knowledge of Indian conditions and you coach the Indian team. This all started in India. Is there something that the confidence level has gone down because of that 4-0 defeat they had in India?
No, look, I think that was part of the indication that Australian cricket was struggling a little bit. I don't think it was a cause in itself. I think it's just we're a little bit light on experience at the moment, and we need to develop that experience. And the only way you do it is to keep playing. And I think the Australian selectors picked the right group to go to India, and they picked the right group to go to England. We just weren't good enough at the time. But the experience that those players have picked up, someone like Steve Smith, for instance, did quite well in India and showed some good signs there, and he's been able to carry that on in England. I think we're going to see others that will have benefited from their experience in England who will do well again this Australian summer. So I think we've got to be a little bit patient. We've got to be prepared to give opportunities to players. Once we've identified the right ones, stick with them, give them plenty of opportunities to find their feet. Very few people arrive in Test cricket ready to go. It takes a little bit of time to develop the knowledge and the understanding to go with your talent.
Well, one thing which is striking, Greg, is the consistent failure of the top order, both in India as well as in Ashes series. Do you think that the local competition, the Sheffield Shield competition, requires a bit of a review to find that the exceptional talents?
I don't think it needs much of a change, really. I think we've got the talent there. We've got the best young cricketers in Australia playing in our domestic cricket. Some of them, we probably had a generation that were held back by the successful period, and those players have all moved on, and we've now got younger players and less experienced players playing in that competition. But give it a year or two and all of a sudden it'll look very different, because those players will have had some experience, they'll start developing, and that will help the competition as a whole. It's very easy to pick fault with things when things aren't going well, but our structures are pretty good, and historically we've come back from these down periods and followed up with a very successful period and some of the best players that we've ever had. And I have no doubt that probably within the next couple of years we'll see the next generation of our champion players start to push through and reveal themselves, and they'll become part of our next successful team.
Greg, the other thing is that today we had the launch of the community initiative. Yes. By Cricket Australia. Do you foresee, you are developing the young talent, do you foresee more people from the subcontinent origin playing for Australia in future?
Oh, I have no doubt. The subcontinental, the South Asian influence is very strong in Australia. So a lot of young kids, we've got a number of them out here at Bankstown today from the South Asian community, but there's Southeast Asian communities, the African African communities, the European communities that don't come from traditional cricket playing countries are the ones that we've also got to encourage to take a closer look at cricket and become involved, the younger members of those communities to start coming and watching cricket, start playing cricket. I have no doubt that in 10 years' time, the Australian cricket team will look very different from the background point of view of where the players come from.
If there is one final advice you want to give to the players of ethnic background, what would that be, Greg?
Well, I think really embrace their own community, but embrace the wider community of Australia. We're very fortunate. It's a great country. Cricket's a big part of the tradition and the history of this country, and we would love to see more of them from diverse backgrounds really getting involved in the game of cricket, and really making themselves a big part of our community and becoming part of the next successful generation of Australian cricket.
Greg, thanks very much for talking to us.
My pleasure.